right, guys, we're just gonna jump right into it. Here we are making floor mats. Floor mats, I hope you guys could see it. I was really into this and I couldn't really sit back, watch what the camera was doing. But you see here, we've got one installed. This is the second one here. This is made with, hold on, let me just pause this here. Okay, guys. Here you saw how I've made the floor mats using my chamois tape and then 2 and 3 millimeter wide Tamiya tapes, just to put a just sort of a pattern on there so that it looks you know, like something and not just a flat piece of tape. It's got a border around it. All of that was done, and when it's done, it should look like this after painting, which is where it's going to now. And that gives us a floor mat with a bit of a tread pattern on it, which should look pretty cool in the car. So now we're gonna head off to paint. Hey guys. We're gonna talk about mounting the mirrors on the Fiero. As you may know, the mirrors don't have any particular mounting pins or anything that or allow you to align them to the door without, well, if you're lucky, you can stick them on once and not have a glue mess, but if not, then you're going to have a bit of a mess on your door. So I'm going to show you how I resolve that, and make it really easy to mount these mirrors with just a couple of simple steps. Now, the first thing I do is I'm going to create a pin for this mirror that will allow it to be mounted to the door. Now, the way I do that is I take the mirror. I'm very careful to keep the angle of that I'm going to install the pin at the same angle that if you can see that there. I'm not sure if you can. If you can see that there, the angle of the mounting stalk of the mount for the mirror goes in this way. So I have to keep the pin at that same angle so that when the mirror goes into the door, it'll go in and sit straight. So what I'm going to do is first thing is just center my drill right there. I think that's about center, and I'm going to take the flat area that actually glues to the door and I'm going to go there. And then I'm going to keep the drill at the same angle. Let me just make a little pilot hole so the drill doesn't walk on me. There we go. Now I have something to bite into. Right there. So now that I have my drill, it's more or less centered up. I'm going to go in at the same angle as the mount for the mirror. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to drill into the mirror. There we go. We're getting in there. Is all what I have to do in order to get the car ready for paint. This all has to be done first before I think about painting the car. Then this is the pin that I use. I've already pinned this mirror, as you can see what I'm talking about with the pin at an angle. So now we're going to take this pin. I'm going to make sure it fits and it sits there at the right angle. And I think that we are good there. Let's see. have to drill it a little bit deeper. Now we should have pretty solid mount, and there we go, guys. We have both mirrors pinned. Now we're just gonna use a little super glue to glue the pins into the mirror, and then we're gonna take a snip, then we're gonna drill the holes in the body in order to mount the mirrors. All right, now that we have our mirrors pinned, as you can see here, we now have mounting pins for the mirrors. Now we just have to set them up on the body so that we can make sure we can drill our holes in the right position and get our mirrors installed where they need to go. Pretty good there. And there we go, we have all our mirrors adjusted and ready to be mounted. So we're going to remove them and paint the body. So that's done. Now what we're going to have to do is make our rear wing adjustments. So the first thing we're going to do is cut the rear wing loose, as we're going to have to make the post from building this model previously. I know that the posts for the rear wings don't exactly line up with the body perfectly. Meaning that we have to make it fit correctly. Let's just clean the edges of the wing. That's much better. Cleaning off all the edges, rounding them off the way they should be. Sure the ring is smooth so we don't have any waves in the paint when we're ready to paint this thing. There we go. Now we need the wing stands, which are here. First we have to get the trunk lid.
Okay.
Now this is how I adjust my wing stands. This model is good, but it's not, to me, a fit good. So you have to make adjustments. now we have the wing stands installed and they're flush on the deck lid. Now, don't know if you guys can see this from here, but the wing stands are not exactly sitting at the exact same angle. This is where you have to start fiddling around with the wing until you get it right where you want it. And then you're going to apply the glue. But first thing we're going to do is get rid of these injector pin marks. Not that they're really going to be super visible once the wing is on the car. So it's really not something we have to kill ourselves worrying about. But as you can see here, you have the wing stands on the deck lid. If you try and install the wing, they don't exactly, I don't know if you guys can see this here. Let's see if I can show this to you guys. They don't exactly line up 100% perfect. And this is where you're gonna have to make a little bit of adjustments here and there to get them to sit, particularly this one here. There we go. Okay, so now we know that we can get the wing to sit exactly where we want it. So let me clean up a little more of these injector pin marks, and then I'll show you exactly what we do to install the wing. There we go, no more injector pin marks. Now what I do is I grab my Tamiya. Extra thin. Is this one empty? Yep, this one's empty, so we're not grabbing that one. Seem to be, oh, here it is. Before I crack open a new one. Now, let's readjust this here so that we know we're flush on the wing. Everything is good. Okay, wing is flush on a deck lid. Oh, and then we accidentally break the pins that hold it in. Okay, that's not good. All right, so now we only have to line up one. Okay. This is not the end of the world. So what we're going to do, luckily we have more of these models. So this is not the end of the world. As we're going to put that one in, and while that's curing, we're going to set this one in. And let's make sure that this sits over the hole that... small pin in this one also. Didn't really see this coming. Thank you. reapply our glue to the wing stands and glue them right to the wing. Okay, this is not working. Okay, after our slight mishap with the wing, we got it all together. Installed two new metal pins. And we are good to go again. So basically, but my procedure for installing the wing is pretty much the same, whether I'm using the metal pins or not. As installing them into the trunk lid and lining them up straight on the trunk lid and then installing the wing and just moving everything until it you can make all the adjustments needed to get them to sit in the wing flush. Then you apply the glue. I flip it upside down and I apply the glue to the stands on the wing so that it dries in the right position, which is what we have here. Now, we'll have to trim down our pins, but that will be after the glue has had a chance to cure. And we still have our spare wing for future use.